greetings. As you could probably tell from the intro that you just saw, it's Christmas. Now, there's always many traditions of Christmas season. Of course, you saw all the decorations, making the Christmas tree, having a nice hot glass of cider, watching your favorite movies or cartoons about Christmas, putting up the lights, oh, all that great stuff. Oh, and of course, I almost forgot, one of the biggest traditions of all time. It happens every year. I can't believe I forgot, of course. When the businesses and corporations shove advertisement down your face so you can spend every last penny on presents. Ah, the holidays. But of course, there's many great things about this. There are some amazing advertisements. Funny, heartwarming. Really gets to you. And makes you spend your money. But anywho, these commercials are kind of big. Just like the Super Bowl ones, you have many memorable things. You know, it got me thinking. My channel has a lot of soda stuff on it. Heck, it even has some soda commercials on the video list. So I thought, why not celebrate the spirit of Christmas and its over-advertisement by celebrating the top 10 soda commercials.
I've always wanted to do a top 10 video, and now I have my chance. Now these commercials are going to be ones I've seen from either TV or the internet. I am sure there are a lot of soda commercials I have not seen. So if you think there should be one on this list, I most likely have not seen it.
So, let's not waste any time. Here are my top 10 favorite soda commercials.
This one at number 10 is at number 10 for a good reason. I stumbled across it on the internet about 2 years ago, and I like it for one reason. It's epic. On this list, there are more than one sentimental commercials, but I felt like this one had to be included as it represents the fight between Coke and Pepsi, and how they always try to make sure that they have an edge over one another. Also, this commercial is pretty epic with its music, animation, and the soda cans fighting. This commercial is different from most commercials in general, and that's why it's number 10.
Go on out to the lobby, go on out to the lobby, go on.
Nesbitt's Orange!
Nesbitt's Orange!
Nesbitt's Orange!
Wonderfully orangey! Orangey good! Good! Good, good!
Nesbitt's Orange!
Nesbitt's Orange!
Nesbitt's Orange soda pop! Soda pop! Soda pop! Wonderfully!
At number 9, this commercial stuck with me when I found it when I was looking for footage for my Nesbitt soda documentary. This classic Nesbitt's Orange commercial had a lot in it that made it feel nostalgic. I grew up on Disney and Cartoon Network, and this commercial reminded me of how branding on products were back then when I was younger. I know the commercial is older than me, but it still is a reminder of how advertising used to be. More carefree and fun with bright colors and happy music. This commercial brings me back to a more simple and happy time. And that's why it is number 9.
Sorry, I'm going to take that.
I drink Dr. Pepper, don't you see? 'Cause it's the perfect taste for me. That original taste, you know. It's making peppers everywhere I go.
At number 8, this is probably on a lot of people's favorite soda commercials, as it is a major classic. This commercial is a symbol of what Dr. Pepper has always advertised themselves as, being different, or as they say it, being a pepper. Even up to this day, Dr. Pepper has always printed themselves as a unique soda, and this commercial paints that image perfectly. With the two bigger sodas mostly fighting, Dr. Pepper made this happy, cheerful, and catchy tune with this commercial to show that they were different. I love this commercial for what it is representing and also its historical importance. And that is why it is number 8.
Come on, baby, let the good taste flow. You got the one that
feels very special about the taste of 7-Up that's unlike any other soft drink. Maybe because 7-Up has no artificial flavor and no artificial color. Never had it, never will. And no caffeine. Never had it, never will.
Jeffrey Holder does an amazing job advertising the Un-Cola 7-Up. As Coke and Pepsi duked it out for the best cola, 7-Up tried something different. Instead of trying to join the cola race, 7-Up said, why not try something different? And they did justice with the Un-Cola advertising. I love these commercials for how they talk about clean and crisp lemon lime is, and would make any lemon lime soda lover mouths water. And Jeffrey Holder and how he describes 7-Up is just amazing to say the least. The commercial is different and unique. And with that amazing narrator is why it is number 7.
They changed my Coke.
Something wrong.
Coca-Cola wasn't the first to show Santa in red and white, but they sure made it famous. Santa's image was popularized by Coca-Cola advertisement with the big jolly Santa with a long white beard and a red suit. Before that, Santa was projected as like an elf man. And so many years after that, Coca-Cola has still represented Santa well during the holiday season. And all the commercials with Santa and Coca-Cola is always a treat to see during the holidays. And it is a great reminder of how Coca-Cola has impacted the holiday season. All Coca-Cola Santa commercials are number 6 for that reason.
Like to buy the world a home and furnish it with love. Grow apple trees and honey bees and snow white turtle doves. I like to teach the world to sing.
Sing with me.
Perfect harmony.
Perfect harmony.
I like to buy the world a Coke and keep it company.
This might be the most famous soda commercial in history. As I asked friends and family about soda commercials, almost every time this was the first one that came up. To this day, Coca-Cola has always said that their soda brings people together, and this commercial represents that message in the biggest way possible. With people from all over the world singing a very catchy and happy song that emphasizes that the whole world should just sing together. And also buy a Coke for one another. This commercial is just heartwarming, unique, fun, and which is why it is number 5.
Tradition back when swing was in style.
I don't even know if these polar bears or the commercial need to be explained. Coca-Cola definitely made the right move to have polar bears in their commercials when making Christmas commercials. They already had Santa, but Coke got even more popular during the holidays when these cute and funny bears were on TV screens. There are also no words, none needed to be said. Just let the characters of the polar bears and their love for Coke do the talking. These commercials were so famous, they even got a short film in 2013, which was produced by Ridley Scott. Truly, these commercials and the polar bears are magical, which is why they are number 4.
Time for Hires, that real old-time root.
A large pepperoni pizza.
And a Pepsi, please.
A Pepsi. Sure thing, Curly. Here you go, Cupcake.
Thank you.
Hey, come here. I want you to listen very carefully to what I'm going to tell you. We both know I ordered a Pepsi Cola.
I remember this commercial vividly. Whenever I think of my first soda commercial memories, this is one of the first I remember. Clearly playing of the Godfather films, it has the right atmosphere, and it catches your attention. And a lot of people, including younger me, were surprised when the little girl started talking in a different voice. And she pulls off the acting in the commercial very well. What else can I say? This is a classic and loved commercial. It has a great atmosphere, acting, and is pretty funny when you think about it. It makes me smile, which is why this commercial is number 3. But come to think of it, there's one other commercial I can remember before this one.
Yahoo! Mountain Dew!
Now, this is the first commercial I remember when I think back to my childhood. It has always amazed me for the fact that so much can be said in this commercial, yet no words are ever spoken. Kind of like my When You Mix Coke and Pepsi video. There is no need for anything to be said, just let the acting talk. And this commercial definitely shows the message of what Coke is trying to get across. In the commercial, these two boarding lands clearly dislike each other, and would do whatever they can to make sure nothing comes in and out from each other. But even with the massive amount of hate, one of the soldiers starts to drink a Coke. The other soldier sees the other one on the hot day, and the one drinking the Coke decides to give him a Coke as well. Even though they have trouble giving and receiving it from one another, due to which country they live in, but they both take a drink and they both forget their differences and smile at each other. Not as enemies, but as people. Living creatures. But then they go back to their work of guarding. But the message Coke is trying to send, that Coca-Cola can bring people together, and is shown strong in this commercial, even in those small seconds. Coke is still making commercials like that to this day, where we can put aside our differences and drink a Coke and get along as people. But I believe no other commercial can represent it more than this one, which is why it is number 2.
Want my Coke? It's okay, you can have it.
When I first saw this commercial, I was amazed by so many factors and how this commercial did it right. Coca-Cola and Pepsi have always tried to outdo one another, including in commercials, and I think no other commercial shows more meaning than this short commercial here. You have a young kid who spends money to buy two Cokes and steps on top of them as if they're nothing more than a rock on the ground to buy what he really wants, a Pepsi. He doesn't even take the Cokes with him. I can't think of anything more insulting to do to your rival. You buy a product. You use it as a stepping stone to get what you really want. You just leave the product behind in the dust. And again, no words needed. You just see two perfectly fine Coca-Cola cans stepped on, and nothing more. To this kid, they aren't even worth his time. All those cans are to him are temporary stares. And in my opinion, this is the strongest message Pepsi can say to Coke. Not some celebrity endorsement or Pepsi Coke challenges. It's this, where Pepsi literally barely acknowledges Coke's very existence. They did this commercial perfectly, which is why this is my favorite soda commercial of all time. Hey guys, thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe if you haven't for updates on future videos. You could also follow me on Facebook and Twitter. If you wish to see more soda related videos, click here these annotations to see soda documentaries on Dr. Enough or Werner's Ginger Ale. Thank you for watching, everyone, and have a very Merry Christmas.